very lonely and depressed, and the only thing around is your cat, and you want contact, you want it badly. So then the way you pick up your cat and hold your cat becomes different. Right? Then so we start with just the action itself, and then we build up layers on layers on layers on layers. Suppose I ask you to iron a shirt, you may get the details of it very correctly. Then I'll add on a layer. I'll say you're ironing that shirt because you're going for an interview. You're going to wear that shirt for an interview. And a lot depends on that interview. You badly need the job. Your family is in financial straits. You have to, you're not going to get many more chances to get that job, a job like that. You've got to impress the people taking your interview. You've got to be at your very best. Then the way you'll iron that shirt will be entirely different from the way you were ironing the shirt if you're just going out for a movie with your friends. And so on. So, as always happens in any dramatic situation, an urgent intention. Suppose I ask you to perform that action of ironing your shirt, but I tell you that last night you slept wrong and so your neck is very stiff. Now iron that shirt. You don't have to indicate to me your neck is stiff, you have to believe your neck is stiff. Everyone's had a stiff neck, but to recreate that feeling of the neck being stiff, it takes some imagination and some concentration. You really need to focus hard. So that is the way you will be taught to use your imagination, use your concentration, use your observation. It's very funny. I've been to NSD, and then I taught acting many, many years later. I taught acting for 4 years at the Whistling Woods under Nasiruddin Shah, and when I watched students doing what I had to do, I learned a lot more than when I actually did it. You learn a lot more while you're teaching than when you're actually learning. And so when I watched Lavia, for example, I remember the first imagination exercises that I had done and all the mistakes that I had made. And it's a whole process of discovery of how you it's amazing how once your imagination kicks in, when you have supplied your mind with enough details, you really start believing what you're doing. You start believing the story, you start believing in the relationship, you start believing in that situation. And once you start believing in that situation, you're just sailing as an actor. And that's what a new actor, when he does it, or he or she does it well, or when a very experienced actor does it well. You hit the ball right, whether you're Sachin Tendulkar or whether you're in the Harris Shield, you hit the ball right, it's going to go for a four. So you hit the ball right when you're an actor, you'll get it right then. And that's the way we will build it up from moment to moment, layer on layer, layer on layer, to the point where you are comfortable using your imaginations, using your observation. When you start doing an action the first time, it's very hard to get it right. You don't really understand the exercise. The second, third, fourth time you try, you become over deliberate. You concentrate so hard, you do everything in slow motion almost. Then you get used to it and you start doing it with the right amount of effort, the right amount of concentration. And then you've got to be able to do more than one thing at a time. Like when you're learning to drive a car, that's all you can do, right? Your concentration is totally on the clutch, the accelerator, the gear shift, the steering wheel. And if someone tells you, say you're 3 times tables while you're doing it, you'll get totally thrown because it requires so much of your concentration. But once you've been driving a car for some time, then you'll be able to do pretty complicated things while you're driving the car. You might be able to have a business conference while driving the car. Not that I'm advising it. Please don't talk on your mobiles while you're driving. But you could possibly do, and you could do multiple things at a time. You could talk on the phone, smoke a cigarette, and make a nimbu pani at the same time. But that's when you've developed your acting muscles. So it's all about developing your acting muscles. It's all about putting in a lot of effort. It's about observing others, observing yourself. It's like putting yourself in a laboratory where you are the product. One of the most fantastic things about acting as an art is any other artist requires something else. The painter requires his canvas and his paints. The musician requires his musical instrument. And the writer requires a pen and paper, and the sculptor requires a block of marble. But for the actor is himself or herself, his own musical instrument, his own pen and paper, his own paint, his own block of wood, which he works on. And the acting program is about starting you off on that journey. It's unending. 3 months is just enough to start, maybe. But really speaking, there is no end to it whatsoever. But once you're on the path, you can keep walking by yourself. So that's what it's about.
Thank you, sir. Now we would like to keep the forum open for the audience to pose their questions. I'm sure you all are very curious and excited to pose questions to Mr. Kenneth Desai and to our veteran actor here. So anybody in the audience would like to ask questions? Could you give her the mic?
I would like to ask Mr. Kenneth, what is the one director that who really inspires you except Anurag Kashyap?
May I please answer a question with a question? Why do you want to know about one director? Well, I worked with a theatre director. I did a workshop with him and I did a play with him many years ago. He was a German director called Wolfram Mehring. And he'd done a lot of research on the body and body movement, and I found him extremely inspiring. But I'm really curious, because it's not really important who's my experience and your experience will be totally different. And yeah, sure. I mean, there are lots of directors I'd like to work with. It's a wish list, but I'm happy to work with any director on whom I'm on the same page with. As would any actor be. Any actor, you need to trust your director. Your director needs to trust you. When you feel that your director has faith in you as an actor, it's a wonderful feeling as an actor. It frees you up. It gives you loads of confidence and the freedom to really explore the role and not hold back. You're just not trying to please. You're trying to create something together. Any such director is fantastic to work with.
Anybody else in the audience? Yes, we have. Sure.
Yes, it does not necessarily have to be a formal training. It could be an informal one. Some people learn on the job, some people go to school. Some people can learn the same things at home as well. But training makes it easier. Training makes it more convenient in many, many ways. And there are two ways to learn swimming, you know. Someone might just take you in a swimming pool and push you off at the deep end, and you learn how to swim because you have no choice. But for a lot of people, that's a very traumatic way of learning swimming and can scar people for life. I think a lot of people would benefit by learning how to move their bodies, learning the stroke, and then carrying on. It's gentler. You'll probably learn to swim better and not just dog paddle. You'll probably learn different strokes, like the freestyle and the breaststroke and the dolphin stroke. Similarly, if you go for training, you'll get more approaches to. There's more than one way to skin a cat. There's more than one way to learn acting, and you'll probably learn many more ways of approaching your work as an actor if you undergo training than if you don't.
So at Jai Hind, we have all natural talents. They all are natural actors. But I believe, yes, training is required just to polish their skills here and there. So I agree with that. Anybody else? Could you just circulate the mic? Yeah. Yes. Pass the mic.
How to use casting couch in this industry? Compromise.
Well, to be honest, from personal experience, I have never experienced it. So, let me not be facetious. Yes, it exists. At the same time, it is not the only way to success. And you can have lain on any number of casting couches, but if you're no good as an actor, you're not going to get anywhere in spite of all that.
Two last two questions. I know many of you are want to ask, but please refrain. Yeah, please give her the mic. She has a question. If you're loud enough, you can.
Very, very difficult. I've been trying to become a star all my life. I haven't succeeded. But I'm happy being an actor.
Again, typical Jain answer. Copy, paste, save. Yes.
Sir, you have done a lot of villain films. When I saw the first villain, it was a rape, that was what happened. और मैंने आप यहाँ पे भी देखा है, जैसे आपने बंदूक से स्टार्ट किया है, वो शूट किया है, ये शूट किया है, तो कभी मतलब क्या चीज आया है जो पहले फिल्मों में होता था कि विलन का रोल और एक विलन के रोल में?
मैंने विलन का सोच के ही कहते हैं
कि
अच्छा, यू टॉकिंग अबाउट द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ विलन, द बैड विलन टू द न्यू विलन.
मैंने जो ये कैरेक्टर किया, मैंने सोच के नहीं किया कि विलन का कैरेक्टर है. मुझे बताया, मेरे डायरेक्टर ने मुझे बताया था कि इसकी अच्छाइयाँ ये है, इसकी बुराइयाँ ये है. जो ग्रे कैरेक्टर मैंने किया है, अब उसको आप विलन बोलो क्या बोलो, आई डोंट नो, मुझे नहीं मालूम. बट मैंने अपने दिमाग में ये सोच के किया था, ये एक ऐसे इंसान है. दैट्स इट.
क्या
मुझे देखना चाहते हो? अरे क्यों मुझे वहां भेज रहे हो यार, मैं यही ठीक हूँ। अब ग्रेसफुल कोई अच्छा बड़ा कैरेक्टर मिलेगा तो डेफिनेटली करूंगा, मैं क्यों नहीं करेगा। एक्टर को क्या चाहिए, अच्छा एक अच्छा काम चाहिए, ऐसे नहीं चाहिए। लेकिन जैसे हमारे यहाँ के जो बहुत सारे एक्टर्स होते हैं और पागल रहते हैं ना कि कुछ भी मिल जाए, मैं वैसा नहीं चाहता हूँ। एक ग्रेसफुल कैरेक्टर कभी भी होगा लाइफ में, एक आध कोई करेंगे। ये सबके साथ काम करना चाहता हूँ, एक थोड़े ना, बहुत सारी सारी खूबसूरत है, सबके साथ काम करना चाहता हूँ।
I think you're very respectable, and of course the audience really love you, your roles and your performance. Really appreciate it. I think we'll have a last question.
We keep the house open for another 5 minutes. People who have the questions, I guess this side many people want to ask.
Yeah, I think Parth wants to ask one question.
Yeah, Parth.
मैं तो शादीशुदा हूँ। पैदा तो मैं भी शरीफ हुआ था, पर शराबत से अपने कभी नहीं पड़ी। जरा भी तो देखे कि हमसे बड़ा शैतान कौन पैदा हो गया।
There's somebody in the black
here. Yeah. Black t-shirt.